Hello students, welcome to the new session of velocity analysis using instantaneous center method. Today we will be discussing a very interesting problem from GATE exam. The problem is something like this. For the audio cassette mechanism as shown in figure, where is the instantaneous center of rotation, that is point P, of the two spools? This is the question from GATE 1999. So the locations, the options are given as point P lies on the left of both the spools but at infinity along the line joining A and H. So these are the spools, these two rings or wheels, these are known as the spools on which the tape, this is the tape on which the tape actually unwounds and wounds. Second option is P lies in between the two spools on the line joining A and H such that PH is equal to 2AP. Point P lies to the right of both the spools on the line joining A and H such that AH is equal to AP. And the last option is point P lies at the intersection of the line joining B and C and the line joining G and F. This is quite an interesting problem, but students find it difficult to solve. So let's see how to do the velocity analysis of audio cassette mechanism. Before we move ahead, let's draw the configuration diagram. The configuration diagram is as follows. So to draw the configuration diagram, we draw two circles, each representing one spool, spool 2 of radius 20 mm and spool 3 of radius 10 mm about point A and H respectively. And we mark the various given points as B, C, D, E, F and G as per the configuration given. So we fix the frame 1 and the bigger spool is link number 2 and smaller spool is link number 3. Now this tape can be unwinding from the bigger spool and it will be winding on the smaller spool. Or it can be also vice versa, that it can be unwinding from the smaller spool and winding on the bigger spool. So for now, we are assuming that these spools are rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. So the tape is unwinding from the bigger spool and winding on the smaller spool. Right? So this is the configuration diagram as per the diagram given in the problem. Now, as we have three links, link number 1, 2 and 3, so as per the formula, the number of instantaneous center will be n is equal to n into n minus 1. This will give us the total number of instantaneous center as 3. So they are listed as follows: I12, I13 and I23. So let's locate the instantaneous centers by inspection first. Let's see how many of these instantaneous center we can locate. So as we see here that the link 2 is rotating relative to link 1 about this point A. So there is a relative motion between link 2 and link 1 about this point A. So we can easily say that they are forming a revolute pair. So A will be representing I12. Similarly, we can see that link number 3 is rotating about point H relative to frame 1. So point H can be said as I13. So these are the two instantaneous center which we can easily locate by inspection. So next we have to find the instantaneous center between the two spools. The two spools are 2 and 3. That means we need to find out I23, which in problem is represented by point P. So we need to find out I23. So let's see how we can do this. So up till now we have that point A is the instantaneous center I12 and point H is the instantaneous center I13. Now we have to find out I23. We have to locate I23. So for this we invoke Kennedy's theorem. So according to the Kennedy's theorem, if three rigid bodies are in relative motion, then the three relative instantaneous centers should lie on a same line. They should be all collinear. So therefore, as per the Kennedy's theorem, the I center 2, 3 lies somewhere on line A and H. This is for sure. So we have somehow found out where I 2, 3 will be located. So it should be located somewhere on the line joining A and H, so that they all three are collinear. So I 2, 3 should be somewhere on this line, right? Now let's see where we can find out that the location of I 2, 3 will be. Let's see the problem. Option 1 says that point P lies on the left of both the spools but at infinity along the line joining A and H. So it says that point P or I 2, 3 lies somewhere here, left on both the side, both A and H, but at infinity, means on this line at infinity. So let's see whether it is possible or not. Second is, point P lies in between the two spools on the line joining A and H. This is very much clear from the Kennedy's theorem. It will definitely lie on line joining A and H. So these things are common in three of the options. But the difference is here, PH is equal to 2AP. And in this, AH should be equal to AP. In option B, it is lying on between the two spools. And in option C, it is lying on the right of the both the spools. So let's see. So that means according to option 2, it should be somewhere here in between. And according to option C, it should be somewhere here. But still, we are not confirmed where it should be. So let's see option D. The point P lies at the intersection of the line joining BC and GF. Means these two lines. So BC is produced here. Similarly, GF is produced here. So on these extension, they will be meeting somewhere far away from this line AH. So according to the Kennedy's theorem, this will not be possible, as the intersection point of BC and GF will never lie on this line joining A and H. So we can say that option D is not possible. Next, let's use the angular velocity ratio theorem. We studied this earlier in the previous videos. So we should use this angular velocity ratio theorem. So according to angular velocity ratio theorem, omega 2 upon omega 3 will be I 2 3 minus I 1 3 and I 2 3 minus I 1 2. So let's see. We see that bigger spool is rotating with the angular velocity of omega 2 and smaller spool is rotating with the angular velocity of omega 3. So omega 2 upon omega 3 is now PH upon AP. How? I 2 3 is represented by P and I 1 3 is nothing but H. We have seen here I 1 3 is H. Similarly, I 2 3 is again P and I 1 2 is nothing but point A, as seen here. So we have omega 2 upon omega 3 as PH upon P. Next, again, we should see this, that the velocity with which the tape is unwounding from the spool 2 is V2 in this direction, as the spool 2 is rotating in the anticlockwise. Similarly, the velocity of tape which is entering or it is winding on the spool 3 is V3. So at any instant, these two velocities have to be same so that the tape can unwound and wound properly. Otherwise, it will mix up inside the cassette. So these two velocities have to be same. So let's see that V2 is equal to V3, and V2 can be written as omega 2 into the radius of the bigger spool and the link number 2, and V3 is omega 3 into radius of smaller spool, that is link number 3. So from this we get omega 2 upon omega 3 is equal to 1 upon 2. So finally, from these two relations, we have we can write that PA is equal to 2PH. This PA will be equal to 2 times PH. Let's see what we'll have in the questions or in the options now. Now, as per this option A, P lies on the left on both of the spools, but at infinity along the line joining A and L. So this is also not possible, because as per this relation we have obtained, that is not possible. Now, these are the two options remaining, option B and option C. Point P lies in between the two spools such that PH and is equal to 2PA or 2AP. But we are getting PA is equal to 2PH. So this is still not the right answer. So let's try the option C, which says point P lies to the right of both the spools on the line joining A and S such that AH is equal to AP. So let's see whether this is possible or not. Now, we have A and H here. So let's see, can we plot P such that AH is equal to AP, and also PA is equal to 2PH. So let's see, can we do this? Now, this is the same two points A and H as they were on the mechanism. Let's try to plot P such that the same distance AH is being plotted. We are taking that AH is equal to HP as per the option C. So let's plot point P here such that AH is equal to HP. Now, if we are taking AH is equal to HP, whether we will be able to prove that if we are taking AH is equal to AP, whether we will be able to prove that PA is equal to 2PH. If this is proven, then the option C will be the correct answer. So let's see. In this figure, PA, this distance PA is equal to AH plus HP. But HP is equal to AH. So we can write this. From this, we can write this PA is equal to 2HP. So that means we are fulfilling our previous relation which we derived earlier. So that means answer option C is the correct answer. If PA is equal to 2PH, then AH is equal to HP also. So this is how we get option C as the correct answer. Point P lies to the right of both the spools on the line joining A and H such that AH is equal to AP. So we are fulfilling both the conditions. It is lying on the right side also, and AH is also equal to AP. So this is how we solve this interesting problem. I hope now you have understood how to go through these types of problem, and I wish you all the luck to practice and solve more gate problems and also the problems from your textbook. Thank you very much.